was not long after her 18th birthday when our heroine, Belle, set off from home. She was going to make her fortune in the Hills of Plenty. It was a fine land, lush and fertile, a land flowing with biscuits and gravy. And so she loaded up all her possessions into a wagon and set off on her grand adventure. Although she had no man, no mule, or even a hole waiting for her, she wasn't afraid. With her trusty six-shooter at her side, she felt confident of her ability to defend herself. No Indian or bandit would dare mess with her. And so, without heeding the warnings of her wise old pappy, she advanced into the Gorge of Despair. Bandits beat Belle and stole all her possessions. They took her money, they stole her wagon, and then they laughed at her foolishness for wandering alone into the gorge. They then disappeared into the hills, leaving her half dead for the coyotes and the vultures to finish her off. Without a friend in the world, it seemed like she was doomed. All of a sudden, she spotted someone approaching. Eagerly, she began waving at the man. Why, she was not alone anymore. Oh, why, if it wasn't Sheriff Wilson, the most upstanding man in town. Why, surely this brave lawman would come to the aid of a law-abiding citizen in need. But when he spotted her, he walked over slowly and then issued a citation for lying on a public thoroughfare and obstructing the road. He then proceeded to just walk on by. Her cries for help fell upon deaf ears. Why, our poor heroine could feel herself fading out of consciousness when she spotted the Wells Fargo stagecoach! Instantly, she felt revived. She'd been a loyal Wells Fargo customer her entire life. She even signed up for one of them rewards programs. Oh, surely they wouldn't want to lose a paying customer. Again, she waved at them and called after them. But once again, her pleas for help were ignored. And all she could do was watch them speed on by and then grow distant in the waning light of the day. Things certainly weren't looking good for our Belle. There she was, and passed out in the road when she heard someone approaching. Looking up, she could make out the silhouette of someone leaning over her. Why, she rubbed her eyes and could scarcely believe that it was an Indian. Oh, why, she'd always been told to avoid them natives because they were savages and thieves, as likely to slash your throat as they were to smile at you. She thought this was curtains for her. Instead of trying to steal anything the bandits might have missed, this little Indian girl knelt down beside Belle. She tended to her wounds. She gave her water to drink. She wrapped her up in a blanket. And then, she helped her to the neighboring town. Thanks to this Indian girl, this good Samaritan, Belle was able to make it to the Valley of Plenty. She was able to build herself a farm get married, and become independently wealthy. Those bandits, in the end, they really didn't get much of value. Just a diary and some girls' clothes was all.